Yo guys, welcome to RenderRam, my name is Vieco, and today I'm going to be talking about dirty windows, and I'm going to be showing you the technique that I use to make my windows dirty in Max. I believe that this technique can be literally used in every 3D software, so I'm going to mark this video as all 3D software. So there is this specific kind of sentiment when it comes to dirty windows, you know. Look at this photo, for example. You got this, you know, nice sunset with like this library, and you got the dirt on the windows. It kind of just feels cozy. Look at this one. You got a, you know, like a living room, cat sleeping, and then these windows. It just feels homey, you know. That's kind of the thing. Look at this. Like, you can really feel like it's weekend and you're just chilling. Dirt is generally a common thing. No matter how much you wash your windows, you will never be able to kind of clean them to perfection. It's just how windows are, you know, that's how God created windows. Like, this cannot be cleaned ever. That's just how windows are. But there is one issue. When you're creating window glass in 3D, it's atomically clean. Like, you don't have a freaking single speck of dirt anywhere, because you just put, you know, reflection 1, refraction 1, IOR 1.5 or 1.6, whatever, and you call it a day. So I made this kind of test. I pronounced the effect a little bit. I think 2 times more than what it should be, but you can easily kind of reduce it down. This was just for demonstration purposes. So this is the render that I did. So you got this little dude chilling here, you know, it's kind of, you know, a sunset outside. Oh yeah, there's also this thing about sunsets. You can also notice that all these images have this kind of, you know, sunset vibe. Because I tried to search for, you know, like midday sun, you know, dirty windows scenarios. And yeah, those windows look ugly. You need to clean them. Anyhow, I got this scenario. And as you can see, the windows are dirty. You can actually see sunray kind of hitting, you know, like corners here. There's like shadows from the trees kind of thing. And then I have that same window without the dirt, and it looks like this. On the other hand, I got a zoomed out scene. And as you can see, you kind of feel the rays of the sun hitting the actual glass, because so this is an example where you just have a raw glass material. You don't feel the ray hitting it. The only like scenario where you see a ray coming in is what is literally happening inside the room. That's the only part where you actually see the rays. But when you add that tiny speck of dirt on the glass, you will be actually seeing, you know, a lot. So look at this. This part is in shadow. This part is directly hit by sun. You got, you know, a sun splotch here. You know, it's everywhere. It's kind of mixed, but you can actually feel that that's actually a glass there. You know, again, keep in mind, I kind of bumped it up here a little bit just for demonstration purposes. But yeah, that's my procedure. So this is the effect that I'm going to show. And let me just start with how I created the whole thing. So this is my material. That's it. I did this in FStorm. Again, this can be done in literally any rendering engine. The procedure is the same. So let's create a glass material. So it's just a regular glass. It's nothing fancy. Like, you know, see reflection on white, refraction white or 1:1. And we got the IOR 1.5, and that's pretty much it. Now, first thing that I did, I had to separate this material into two materials. Why? Because the outer part of the glass is the one that gets dirty, and everything inside doesn't get dirty. So what I did, this is my window glass. It's for this presentation, it's important that you kind of separate each glass to each panel. Don't just, you know, create one big plane out of this. And this is the thing. So I literally, so this is my outside. So I selected all the outer faces, and I've set them to be material ID number 2. Everything else is ID 1. So because of that, I'm going to create a multi-sub object, and I'm going to link this to 1 and going to link this to 2. So this will be my clean glass. I'm not going to do anything with it, but this will be my dirt. Now for the dirt texture, I've been using a texture supply, dirt map window 01. It's this one, and it looks cool. So I don't know, it works nicely. So that's the texture I've been using. Another cool thing is that texture is 2 meters by 2 meters. So you won't be, you know, missing space here. Let me just grab that texture from here. So this is just a raw texture, just loaded in raw texture. So this is my approach. So this will be my front face. Since this texture is 2 meters by 2 meters, I've placed a UVW map, and it just has a box mode, and it's 2 meters, 2 meters, 2 meters everywhere. So for my kind of dirt feeling, I'm using translucency, because translucency has a very nice reaction with, you know, the shadows and the light parts. As you can see here, for example, example, in this photo, you can see how the dirt is super highly pronounced and then the shadowy parts are literally turned off. So translucency does a very nice job with that. So I'm gonna plug this texture into Refraction. So why Refraction? Take a look at this. I will be using translucency. So I'm gonna crank up my translucency to 255 white. So what does that mean? Translucency on 255 white completely ignores the effect of diffuse. Refraction, on the other hand, when it's completely turned on, it ignores the effect of translucency. So refraction kills translucency, translucency kills diffuse. So therefore, if I want to use this as a translucent map, I'm going to plug it in refraction, because all these kind of darker elements in that texture, everything will tone down the refraction and therefore it will release the translucency. And that's the effect that we're going to get. So let me just apply my multi-sub to my glass here and let's see where we at. Our windows look like this. Now, would you look at that? Look at this. This part is in shadow. Look how strongly the translucency part is kicking in. Okay, so now let's start to kind of, you know, improve this. So there is one thing happening with the windows. You can always notice that there is a lot of dirt, you know, kind of towards the edges of the window. You see, like, the edges have more dirt and on the inside it has less dirt. So let's create a mask for that. So I'm going to be using a gradient, and in that gradient, I'm going to set the gradient type to be boxed gradient. So it looks like this, and I'm going to push these black tones all the way to the right, and that will create that border mask. Now, for this mask to work, I have to add another UVW map here, and that UVW map has a face mode on. And because of that face mode, that's why I said in the beginning that it's important to have every glass as a separate element, because face will literally just, you know, stretch the UV across one whole polygon. So I'm gonna create a mix node. And in the mix node, I'm going to use this as a mask. So now if I plug that into my refraction directly, we're going to see this. Well, okay, so there is one thing that I forgot in the UVW map that has the face mode. I forgot that map channel has to be number 2. So now if I go to my gradient and set the map channel to be number 2, we're going to get this effect. So look what happens. You can see how you have the reaction on the corners of the glass, but we want generally the opposite side. So what I'm going to do, so for now, I'm going to make this black color to be completely white, and that will just, you know, ignore all the other effects. And I'm going to plug in my dirt texture into texture 2 here. So now you can see that we got the dirty elements on the edges of the windows. Now that gradient kind of looks like crap. So what I'm going to do, you kind of just want to create like an easy kind of curve, you know, to this gradient. So I'm just going to, you know, mess with it like this, and then this, and then just push this one here. Just as you can see, you know, it just kind of smooths it out. Now you can literally play with those values. You can even, you know, push it like here, just so that you kind of get, you know, that kind of organic a little bit feeling. And now for the inside of the glass, I'm going to be using a color correction node, and I'm going to plug my dirt into the color correction node, and I'm going to plug that into texture 1. Let me just organize this a little bit. Okay, so we got this. So with that texture 1, now you just need to play with the values, because you don't want your kind of windows to look like this. So I need to increase actually the opacity here, and it will just make my glass, you know, kind of react less to the translucency. There is also one cool thing. If you want to see how like all the sun rays are going to react on the windows, you can always go to your actual material and you can just kill the refraction, because when you kill it, you're going to see 100% translucency. So look at this. When you kill it, you actually see where those shadow rays are going to hit. You can literally see where these effects are going to be, so you don't need to guess. You know, if you create this effect and you're not sure if you're seeing things correctly, this is your kind of guide that will show you where things are exactly. Okay, so now you just need to literally play with contrasts here. So I'm just going to make this a little bit stronger so that it's kind of more killed on the inside. I can also increase the gamma a little bit just to kind of make it more subtle. I'm actually going to add another color correction to our border. So this part is our inner part of the window and this part is our border. So for our border, I can also just, you know, increase it up a little bit just so that it kind of, you know, is not as strong. So But it has to be strong, you know, the point is, it has to be stronger than this one. So this one has to be stronger than that. So this is the effect that we got now. Now, one thing that I added is in the refraction, you can notice that like the more you lower it down, you can notice how that fogginess kind of kicks in strongly. So what I did, I kind of figured this number out. So 0.985 is kind of the value that kind of, you know, as this light foggish effect, it doesn't, you know, kind of smudge things too much. And of course, now if we want to fine tune our things, you can go to that close up camera. In here, let me just kind of select this area here clearly. So here, I just want to see, you know, what's exactly happening. So I can feel the border dirt, you know, nicely kicking in. And here you can actually fine tune things. So let me just play with my brightness or offset and just see where will it take me. So let's see. Okay, this doesn't look too bad. So again, if you're kind of curious, why is, you know, this part brighter and why is this part darker? You can always go to your material, kill your reflections just to see if maybe that's a shadow. And yes, this part is in shadow. This part is on a direct sunlight hit. So from this point, I can actually start to increase my translucent effect. So let's say to something like this. I just want to see, you know, the dirt slightly. Now from this point, we can go to our inner glass dirt, and here you can just lower this down just to see, you know, where the effects are happening, and then you can just increase them up, you know, to the point that you're happy with. Again, if in any scenario you need to lower down the effect, you can just go here to your color correction and go to the brightness part in F-Storm that's offset, and here you can literally, you know, play with the results, like crank in the whole, you know, translucency, kill it, edit whatever you want. You can of course play with contrasts, with gamma, whatever, like this is basically how you control, you know, your inner part and your outer part of the whole dirt element. You can actually nicely see that effect here. You see how under the sun it gives a very strong, you know, like milky tone to everything, but the shadowy parts, you can see, you know, like specks of dirt everywhere, but it's not, you know, dusty like it is here. And yeah, this is generally how we create the effect. So this is the glass with the dirt, this is without the dirt. And this is our lovely close-up, you know, with the dirt on the window, without the dirt on the window. So yeah, tone it however you like, increase it, decrease it, it's up to you. Hope you enjoyed this. And just a quick note, the trees that you see in the back, those are Evermotion's Arc Models Volume 283. I think this is their latest tree pack. It has awesome models. Look at this, you get tons of them. And yeah, of course, don't forget to go to the news section because you can learn tons of stuff here. Look at this, topology study, how to model ski goggles in Blender. So yeah, check out Evermotion website, and I hope you like this little tutorial on dirty windows. And yeah, that's it. See you in the next video. Bye.